Hello, this is Mike from Gorilla Kennels.
We're up here at Hart Park in Bakersfield. I came to support my boy Sidewalk Crushers, also Costa Nostra, a couple other kennels that helped put this together, Baco Bullies, all of them real good dudes. We gotta show these people that these dogs ain't all as bad as everybody thinks. I think that's number one. When we throw, you know, barbecues and even some of the bigger shows and you see all these dogs walking around each other and that probably was unheard of about, let's say 6-7 years ago, man, getting a gang of pit bulls together, basically pit bulls slash bullies, and there not being any problems. Pretty much trying to push, you know, the clean side of the bully. There's a lot of dogs that's, inadequate, trying to, you know, produce the complete bully, good wranglerization, good top line, good movement. That's pretty much what Gorilla Kennels is all about. To me personally, just on a dog tip, if this wasn't blowing up or going crazy the way it was, I would still have 5 to 10 dogs. I've always had 5 to 10 dogs my whole life. I think, you know, these dogs are way overpriced. You know, personally myself, you know, I know a lot of people want to get the money and that type of thing, but they putting too high of a price tag on, I would say, non-quality dogs. I just think all dogs should be worth $1,000. Like, that's just me personally. Everybody probably get mad. But the same sense, man, if, think too, this is buying a puppy, man. If it's a gamble, man. You get a lot of people. You get a lot of people that buy puppies and they think they're gonna get the next big thing, man. And they really know how to pick dogs, don't really know how to research the dog, don't really look at what they're really buying other than it has thick bone and a big head. And then when a dog is jacked, you wanna get mad that you paid $5,000 for it. And that's pretty much a lot of the problems that's going on with a lot of the so-called big breeders. The quality is not coming out. Like, if there was, you know, a gang of quality dogs, everybody would be happy, but there's only a few. A lot of people get kind of turned away from me because I ask a lot of questions. You know what I mean? Like, I want to know where these dogs are going to be at. I want to know where they're going to be housed. I want to know if they're going to be shown. Like, pretty much the majority of the dogs that I have sold have been the good friends. Actually, Bully the Kid, he contacted me. We hit it off real good, man, and it was kind of funny because I ended up selling them my pick puppy, which which kind of I don't really want to do, but the position that the dog is in, he has some other UKC dogs, which really I'm into, you know, cleaner dog type of stuff. I think he's going to do real good things with the prophecy. Good dude, actually. Knows a lot more about dogs than I would expect at first, you know what I mean? Just from talking to him, being Bully the Kid and all that stuff. But I think the pup's in a good home, man. He's looking real good right now. Same thing, good fronts, good wranglerization, good movement. Still a puppy, but will be a contender, I guarantee you that. This year is our year. The beginning of next year, we got like 8 or 9 dogs, all pretty clean, that's gonna come out and get a try in a little show ring. But yeah, to expect from my kennel is, you know, a nice dog. If you want something clean, you know what I mean? I'm talking about conformationally clean, not, you know, I guess the board's clean, conformationally clean. I'm pretty much trying hard just to keep producing conformationally clean dogs. A dog that's conformationally sound moves better. A dog that's easty-westy can't really move as much. A dog with a stifle rear end can't move as much. Agility, you start running into a lot of problems that people really don't understand that happens to these dogs just by real poor conformation, I think. This is Sugar Daddy, my foundation male, produced here at Gorilla Kennels off of Patty Cakes and Sugar Free. Sugar Daddy's 16 and a half inches tall, 23 inch head, 74 pounds. To me, he's just a pretty much complete dog. Good fronts, good movements, which you'll see in the video. Nice rear, real short back, nice headpiece, nice stop. Pretty much what we're looking for at Gorilla Kennels to produce over and over again. Pretty much Sugar Daddy, probably one of the cleaner dogs in the game, hands down. He's still pretty young, but he's doing his thing, got some nice productions off of him. Sugar Daddy's the future, man. To me, I produced Sugar Daddy myself. It took me about maybe 2.5 years to find a stud. I think a lot of people don't really take time into finding a stud, but once I found a nice stud, which was Sugar Free, I bred her to Patty Cakes. And if you don't know Patty Cakes, she's off of Dad's and Infamous Miss Shorty.
Runner-up to the Nationals 2 years ago. So I was just trying to pretty much produce something to take to the Nationals and do good, or just pretty much show and show people that there is a cleaner side to these dogs, you know what I mean? Okay, this is Baby Cakes, Gorilla's Baby Cakes, off of Sugar Free and Patty Cakes. We got big expectations for her. She's probably one of the thickest, shortest females out. She still has real nice fronts, real good movement. She's been tearing up the show ring, man. She won the second show at the Nationals, another show under Cassidy. She should be championed out real soon here. She's 75 pounds, 23 and a quarter inch head. Pretty much a she-male, man. The closest thing to a she-male you can get, but still clean. Boots is actually a dog I picked up in the beginning of it. She's more of my foundation female. Not more than Patty Cakes, because Patty Cakes is my foundation female, but I think all kennels should have two foundation females. But this is basically my other foundation female. I've had her for 3 years. She's only been bred once to Sugar Daddy. Puppies are phenomenal. We're gonna start taking her out the beginning of this year until the summer and start showing her. She's 17 and a half inches tall, 78 pounds, real strong front, real great rear angulation, real good movement. She's off of Piggy, which is Short Shot and Diamond, and Coco, which is off of Gamble and Mighty Mia. Gamble and Mighty Mia are two dogs, really good angulation, the reason why I bought her. This is Mike Jordan from Gorilla Kennels. If you guys are interested in, you know, clean dogs or dogs with good movement or confirmation, or any kennel that's out there that's interested in producing clean dogs, or maybe we could work together and do something, I'm at www.gorillakennels.com.